Welcome to another great session of Leader Speaks. Our leader today is a class apart. He's the first generation fearless entrepreneur and has scaled many peaks in his life. The company he steers, Century Ply, is India's best plywood manufacturer and supplier. He's also a promoter and director of Star Cement Private Limited. And both these brands, he has built both these brands in by sheer dedication and conviction. And these qualities come very naturally to him. His earliest business lessons began right at his home. And after dabbling among other areas, he started his first business venture. And around the same time, he has met the current chairman of the Century Ply, and rest, as they say, is history. Ardent lover of golf, trekking, and a marathon runner, let's welcome Mr. Sanjay Agarwal. Thank you so much, sir, for being with us today. And before I pass it on to our moderators for the session today, Vishal and Ramya, can I request our Gopal sir, BGPM chairperson, to speak a few words.
Sanjay bhai, namaskar. Thank you, Anupama. Namaskar. And I think it's a rare opportunity. I did little bit of, I'll not say Google, I did go get into Century Plywood. I did some work for Green Ply, one of my ex-BPA. See, his family, all his family members have done a lot of ventures. And Sanjay bhai, I think Star Cement, I told Sudhito, is working. Very nice personality yours, and we are grateful, as I am Bangalore, as weekend MBA program. See, why I'm saying we get corporate leaders. I did little research on our students after taking over this chair. Many of our students have done extremely well. They come from mixed background. Some come from chartered accountancy, some come from commerce, most of them come from engineering. They work in MNCs, Indian companies. Two, three things that have helped them after their MBA. You are a practicing leader. I don't have to remind you. You have recruited many MBAs. These people take a pause for 2 years to face the changing world. I just saw your talk in No Right Answer, in the barefoot. And Mr. Sanjay I teach leadership agility. I'm grateful to you that you are practicing leadership agility. Many of you go beyond and see at barefoot what Mr. Sanjay has told, how last year when the pandemic broke, of course, he'll tell many stories about his life, his journey as a leader. But I just recollected what I teach in leadership agility you have shared there. So I'm very positive our students will benefit from your experience, insight, and of course, your life stories. More important, I want to request you for three dimensions. Many of our students continue in the corporate and become CEOs, CXOs going forward. Many of them choose same company. And after some time, if they feel they're not getting adequate growth, many people do get growth because I have seen data of 400 respondents. Many people think time to take a pause and start on their own. So you are the first generation. I know your story. I know Green Ply story because Shivaji Mohinta, he was my colleague in BPL, so Green Ply. All of you have done extremely well in Indian entrepreneurship setup and global products there. So how they can become entrepreneurs. Third dimension, even if they chose not to, because many of our alumni have become distinguished alumni, have become very good as entrepreneurs. But some of them chose not to, coming from middle class background, they want to excel. How do they pick up the skill of intrapreneurship? We teach, like, I don't want to name many MNCs come back. We are very large, but I have lost that fire in the belly from the youngsters. How can you teach us entrepreneurship for the top talent, not ordinary talent, intrapreneurship? So I think I said, though I'll stay here for some time, I said, I'll welcome Sanjay sir. And of course, we'll meet after normalcy. I'm no more a member of Tali Club. So you do there. And when you come here, we'll meet up. But I think, please, these are a bunch of very bright students. More important, the courage to take a pause to add value to themselves. They're earning, they're working, they're supporting their family. And in weekends, they're still sharpening their skills for the VUCA world. Thank you, Sanjayji, and all the best. My gratitude from IIM Bangalore. Thank you.
Thank you. So very thank you to you for considering me to be here. All of you, certainly, it's a, you know, I can't think that can I give a stop to myself for 2 years even after I've achieved so much, I have everything, I don't have to worry for money or even business management itself. But still, this courage is big, actually, very big courage. So kudos to all of you, actually, whoever are attending right now.
Let me start this conversation with a topic which is very close to my heart as well, that is fitness. We all agree to the fact that a fit and healthy body is a true fashion statement. But in today's sedentary life, not everyone is enough motivated to give time for our own fitness. As Anupama mentioned, we heard you are a marathoner, mountaineer, golfer, on top of your extremely busy life. Honestly, I personally could not imagine your age by looking at your pic or now over the Zoom. Could you please tell us how do you manage to keep yourself fit along with taking care of everything apart from the fitness?
Good, good. Very good question. Very, very dear to my heart, actually. So we are, this is a question which I really want to talk to youngsters. So the first thing is, you see, we usually use a word known as work-life balance, isn't it? So you see, we need to understand that, is it really work-life balance? Or it's not work-life balance. Is work anything outside life? The whole life, we actually are preparing for, we are studying, we are preparing ourselves. You are preparing again, even after doing all everything, you are again preparing yourself for more work, isn't it? So, you see, the work is part of life. The first thing, let us understand, and we don't need a balance between work and life. That is my, you see, whatever I'm talking is my thinking. Huh? So it could be actually breaking things or may not be liked by you all, but that is how I feel, that actually you don't need the balance between work and life. You see, what we mean by usually work-life balance is, am I playing something? Am I doing something physically? Am I going and playing a guitar? But you think God has given us three things. Tell me what. Can any one of you tell me what three things God has given? No, very simple. Just think very simple. I am a very simple man. So just think simple. The first I will start is the body. God has
given us. Physical body, yes. Yeah,
so what else? What else?
Mind just come and soul. Up.
Yes, absolutely right. So you have got body, mind and soul, these three things. So what actually you require is a balance between these three. So whenever I am playing golf, do you think at that time I am using only my body? I'm using my mind totally. Otherwise, I can't play golf. So it's not that that is not work. I'm using my body, I'm using my mind, and I'm really working at that time. Rather, at times I say that golf takes out more from me than my business. So, you know, a Sachin Tendulkar kind of a person, they work with all the three things, body, mind, and spirit. People like us who have reached somewhere a little bit, we only reach up to body and mind. And what we make a mistake, according to me, you see the elephant in the room, nobody wants to address it. We talk about everything else, but the elephant in the room is a different elephant in our life. And that's why this balance does not come. You see, suppose aapko subha, you like dosa a lot and you have eaten dosa in the morning and dosa in the lunch and dosa in the dinner. What will happen the next day, tell me? Isn't it?
I'll stop eating dosa.
Yeah, no.
So don't you think that that is what we are trying to do with our life? We are working. We are preparing for that work throughout our life. And then again, when we are getting into the work, we are only working. Is that good? And that's why you see, you find this imbalance. There is nothing else. The theory is very, very simple. Even if you start playing, or if you play only guitar, again, there is a problem. If you like marathon, if you do marathon and you do marathon, there is again a problem. So the balance is actually, you need to see that there is a balance in these three things, the mind, body, and the spirit. And one more thing is, you see, what we do during the day, we find that we don't have time. And that is why we are unable to distribute our time into different things, isn't it? So if that is the problem, then I have a solution to it, what I have used for myself. So in the evening, whenever I start feeling like that, then in the evening, I will look at myself, what I did during the day, what could I have thrown out? What could I have actually given to somebody else to do it and I did not have done it? Was it productive for me? So, you know, by within 2-3 days, 4 days, 5 days, 6 days, you will find that you have actually got a lot of time now. And I believe that you don't require more than 8 hours to deliver what you need to deliver. You don't require actually. But our minds are like that. So my request is that look at yourself and you will balance your life. So, and discipline, I think there is another word you were asking. So yes, discipline must come into system. But if you again become too disciplined, again, you will lose everything. So you should not really be totally disciplined. So there should be a lot of indiscipline also in our life. And that is what will give you the energy to be disciplined. You see. The problem is, you see, we are looking at one side of the coin, but the other side of the coin, ke bina, that this side of the coin cannot exist. So you can't be good, good, good. You have to be bad also. Sorry to use all these words for to all of you, but then I think you all understand it better than the earlier generation. You see, in my generation, we were taught that just bloody go work morning till night. And that is how we started our life. So a rikshawala does the hardest work, but he never makes money. So for making money, you don't have to work very hard.
Yeah.
I think I have answered as far as I think. If you have anything else to ask here, you can ask it.
Absolutely.
That's really an aha moment, sir. Thank you for that.
So, sir, I remember as when Ramya was talking about the fitness. So, Ramya, whenever we are in sir's office, it's a like huge office and we get an opportunity to walk also. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to walking with sir, it is like everybody is actually trying to catch up because that is the pace at which sir works. And he lives the entire thing. Like when it comes to fitness, we could understand even at maybe half his age, how... like he would be double the fitness as far as we have.
Yeah, I think this energy that sir carries is really contagious.
Yeah, it's all in the mind.
Yeah,
all in the mind. You see how you control your mind. The mind is the master.
Absolutely.
So just look at your mind every day. Give yourself 2 minutes, just 2 minutes, and you see you will see such a sea change. Such a small thing can change. I'm telling all the hearers, all the people here, to just look at yourself. The moment you are gone, nobody bothers for you.
Yeah.
Don't look at others. Look at yourself every day.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely.
Yes,
so,
please.
Sir, like just say, sir, aap se main itna interact karta hun, so I'm aware, sir, like how you had started. Today you had formed a great company in the name of Century Ply and Star Cements. But, sir, jab aapne shuru kiya tha way back in like mid-80s, sir, I think it would have been a lot of challenges at that point of time. So, sir, हम लोगों को ये जानना है like how was your childhood and how did actually Century Ply got formed or you got into this plywood business and then how did your cement business work out and sir, especially this Century Ply name, how did you coin this name?
I really think yes, there is a story. I will tell you the story a little bit of it, but then you know those parts are not so interesting. Every company has its own something. The history is there actually. You see. So first I will tell you a little bit about my childhood. So my father used to wake me up at 5 o'clock in the morning to go swimming. So I think that instilled that, the physical side into my mind that I should keep on doing something. And since then I have been doing something. So your childhood actually puts in certain things inside you. But it's not that you have lost the battle if it is not done. You can put it later also. And many, many people have done that. So one episode in my life, I remember, is in Durga Puja when I was in class, I don't know, 5 or 6 or something. So, or maybe say class 8. So in Durga Puja is a big thing in Bengal and it's a big thing in Assam. I used to be in Tinsukia, Assam. And so what I did, I went to the main market and I bought the goods which I used to love. I used to buy, you know, those small toys of 25 paisa, 50 paisa or a rupee and all that. And that small gun where you can actually put out something and all that. So I got that and I put it in front of my outside my house on a small stool. and I started selling them there. So, you know, that was my first, you can say, ki ek mind mein tha ki haan bhai kuch karna hai, aisa kuch karna chahiye, kiya maine, but then I was stopped by somebody not to do that, that it does not suit us. So here my point is little different. My point is that if your child, of your brother, or if somebody else is doing something, let him do it. If you stop it, a lot of stoppage comes into your mind and in your background, and which will hurt the person going ahead, you see. So that was one area. Another thing which I really gained was, my father asked me when I was in class 8, to actually, I must clarify one thing. You are telling me first, you know, generation, you know, entrepreneur, but I am not first generation entrepreneur. Yes, Century Ply is a startup which I came out of Assam and started. But my father had business, and he supported me to start this business. And actually, he put in whatever I am today. I am still, you know, I remember how he trained us. So he told us that in class 8, that you come to the shop. We had a hardware shop. We used to sell Jensen Nicholson paint and so many tiles and Godrej things and all that. So he will tell me, hafte mein do ya teen din, do ghante. And you start issuing the cash memos and the chalans, and you know, there is a shop, so there are many, many things. If somebody asks you, Jensen and Nicholson ka 500 ml Azure blue paint chahiye, you must be good enough to know where bloody it is lying. And then someday you don't find it, then you learn about stock keeping. Stock mein hai nahi, the customer is asking and I'm unable to give him. Otherwise I would have made a sale. So then I learned how to keep, you know, at that time we used to keep everything into, you know, manually. So those were really learning, and those small things. And then in class 8, 9, I learned how to make a trial balance or a balance sheet. All those things, there was no accountancy for me, but that those, all those things I learned there. And how, you know, Century Ply progressed. So I will ask you again a question. Have you heard name of Edmund Hillary?
Yeah.
So Edmund Hillary asked a question, and I'm asking you the same question, that you have that mountain in front of you. Now, what is the most important thing you want to climb it? What is the most important thing? Is the training? Is it the training? Is it the Sherpa? Or is it the food? Or is it the medicines? Or is it those tools you use to climb? Tell me, what do you think is the most important thing?
So most important thing to me will be the mindset and willingness to attitude. Take that challenge, the attitude.
Good one, but still I will tell you the main, the most important thing out there is the Everest mountain. Yeah. If the mountain does not exist, nothing
exists. Then nothing exists, yeah.
Okay, so you see, the first thing in your life or in my life, and to stay motivated or to create a Century Ply or to create a Star Cement, the first thing is to find that mountain. We all shy away from problems. But try to understand that problem is the cause of everything in life. Mr. Hillary must have failed 100 times or 50 times or 10 times. But then because of that mountain, everybody, we know about him, and we, Tenzing Norgay and, you know, Edmund Hillary, we know them and we learn from them actually. So first thing is, so when I started life, so I had come from Tinsukia to Kolkata. And there was some money being sent to me from there, which was good enough, absolutely, but it is never good enough, you understand. And then actually, sometimes for some reason, it gets 2 days, 3 days delays. So you see, the ego of a person now works. And then I said, I must now get into some business of myself and I must make money. And that is how the first mountain I realized was making money. And then I started a small unit of door manufacturing.
Okay.
So in the first 2 months, I understood I have done a big mistake, because this business required a lot of bribing, a lot of dining out with drinks. Both do not suit me. So then we went into the Government of India. I hope I'm not stretching it too much.
No, 11, 22.
Yes, I need to be faster. Yes. So The second thing we did also failed because the government of India reduced some duties. We imported the raw material. We set up the plant with Mr. Bhajanka. Now Mr. Bhajanka has come into picture. And the day we were going to start the plant, 3 days ahead of that, government of India increases the duty on that raw material to 100%. So I can't, the imported raw material was lying on the port and I could not clear it. And the second venture also failed. Miserably, total failure, I'm telling you. And practically, we are out of all the money we had at that time. But the third venture was, from the problem itself, a solution came out. Because they increased the duty on the raw material. But the raw material of the raw material, which was timber, the duty was reduced. So we immediately, within 3-4 days, I think the idea came into our mind that let us import timber now and let us make the veneer, which was the raw material for plywood. And that is how the story started. So what I am trying to tell you, ek to failure. So that log bolte hain, nothing like succeeds like success. I say that there is nothing succeeds like failure. So we should love failure, I am telling you. There is, and we should accept failure of each other's also very, very well. Like it's a normal thing. Even Elon Musk, he says that failure is one of the options we have. So I think that is how everything starts and how Century Plywood started. If I go into more stories and more things, it will be boring actually, you know, everybody. Actually, all the companies have
some, I think we'll ask more questions so that we can cover the entire story of your life. I'll continue from what you said, don't stop anyone. Yeah, but plywood industry is still largely unorganized. Aapke shuruaat se leke ab tak, there will be so many forces, so many small and large scale industries who would be wanting to stop you, not just your business but each other's business. Yeah. How did you manage to keep moving with such headwinds and crosswinds right at the beginning of your fight? Like, how did you just not stop?
You see, in plywood industry, we were the last entrant into organized plywood industry. After us, there are no new organized industry players. There are players who are unorganized players. And even then, we could now reach where it is. It is again because we at different times, ek to pehli baat hai ki we never bothered about our competition. We never thought, we never discussed, we never, wo kya karta hai, usko karne do. What we do, what we will do is our problem, and let us work on ourselves, let's not work on anybody else. So that was a very beginning, say that was a principle we have been following. And I think we all should, earlier also I have told you that nobody will bother for you once you are gone. So look at yourself for 2 minutes. So here also I am saying that let us look at ourselves. Let us not look at too much at our competition. Yes, we should learn a little bit things they do better than us. And, you know, in Century Ply, we had started this veneer unit, and then we started a plywood, which was a word known as innovation. People give it a good name, innovation. So we were walking to the near about the boiler division of the plant, and we found that a lot of veneer is getting burned as fuel. Okay. So we thought there, and we have passed through that place many, many times, that the thought never came into our mind. But one day the thought comes that, can we recover this veneer? Can we make some plywood out of it? No. It looks very bad. Who will buy that plywood? Then the thought came, if suppose somebody is selling it for 4 rupees a square feet, if I sell it at 3 rupees a square feet, will somebody buy it? So then the thought mind said, yes, then the people will buy it, because there are uses where actually you don't require very high quality, but a price is more important. And we started that plywood from absolutely wastage, and that became a grand success for us. So this is how actually, you know, the number one point is that look apne taraf internally, we need to look at within ourselves. So I actually give an example. Example क्या है saying है कि every problem has a solution into it, and not only solution, it is an opportunity actually. So when we started, you know, these are very cliche things. Everybody must be thinking I'm speaking very cliche, but actually, yes. When I started, I failed, but the next thing came out from that failure. Second time I failed, the third thing came out from the failure, and then we became success. You see, so. I believe that we went to Arunachal Pradesh, we started our units there, then Arunachal was total. So many failures, you see. The government banned all the units in Arunachal Pradesh, and we lost so much money at that time. We can't believe ourselves right now. But from there, again, we gathered ourselves, our minds, our time, and we said, no, nothing doing. Again, there is a new mountain to us now. Things have failed. You are not doing well. There is a new mountain and you have to now climb it. So the moment you look at the mountain, and then again something will come to your mind, you will certainly make a progress. So we did that. We came out, we started expanding outside from Bengal. We went to North India, we went to South India, and you know, different things happened. So the basic point here is that we need to keep finding that mountain, and then you will be excited about it. You see, automatically, the moment you find the mountain may be different for you know, Vishal and Ramya or Sanjay Agarwal or somebody hearing here, they may be different mountains. But the moment you find that mountain, the mountain comes to you. I tell you, the mountain comes to you. But then we don't probably give it the importance we should give, and so we are not excited about it. But if you really give it a thought, if you really look at the elephant in the, you must have the courage to address the elephant in the room, it is interesting. So yes, I think that is how we kept our competition also on the side. Maybe one more question I will ask you. It's a very foolish question. What is the difference between, say, Ramya and it's not Ramya, because then you can say okay, you are a girl, but say Vishal and our Gandhiji, our it's such a foolish question, but what is the difference between Vishal and Gandhiji?
So maybe his determination level.
Ram Mohan Gandhi, I'm saying.
That's what. So his determination level would have been at a different level, and our determination to basically turn around things, what different, sir? Great willingness.
But then a determination.
I think unka uniqueness is different. Like Vishal is Vishal, Gandhiji is Gandhiji. The uniqueness is only
how? What
is
the differentiator? You see, because वो चेहरा है, वही body है, वही heart है, वो blood है. सब कुछ तो वही है, वही education कर रहे हैं. He went to South Africa to study law. You studied something. I studied something. You see, the only biggest differentiator you will find in people to people, and it's so foolish and so simple, it is the way you think.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't you think that is the only differentiator between your friends, absolutely, between your friend and yourself and your parents or your kids? So you see how I say that why we did and why we could achieve anything we have achieved is because the way we think. We did not try to copy the competition. We have our own values and we have our own ways of doing things. You see, there is no given things that you should now follow this value. The value will come from within you. The idea will come from within you, what excites you. I cannot give you the exciting idea. I tell you, yaar, main to running mein itna maja aata hai, tu run kiya kar. And you think, sala pagal hai, run karta hai, shanti se nahi rehta hai, trekking mein ja raha hai. On trekking mein, you see, you don't get to good bed, you don't get good food, it's so tough, it's so cold, -5 degrees, -7 degrees. So kuch bhi nahi hai, but why the hell do you go? So you see, we all have our different that soch, but this soch is the one which differentiated us from our competition, and that's why we are what we are. Aaj Amazon ko aap dekho, Amazon kept on doing what they kept on doing for so many years, even after the failure, because their thought made it different. So many people die after 2 years, 3 years, so many efforts die, startups we see. It is just the thought. In the same area, somebody who succeeds and so many people fail, in every area.
So, जो बता रहे थे सर शुरुआत में लाइक मे बी अ गोदरेज और समथिंग लाइक सुमानी यूज्ड टू बी इन द सेम शॉप एंड टुडे एक्चुअली सेंचुरी प्लाई इफ यू गो टू एनी हार्डवेयर शॉप और एनी प्लाईवुड डीलर सर इट मस्ट बी सो ग्रेटिफाइंग दैट यू आर द लार्जर प्लेयर विद इन द सेम स्टोर एंड दे आर लाइक वन ऑफ द प्लेयर्स और रादर बीइंग इन द सेम लीग सर इट मस्ट बी वेरी वेरी ग्रेटिफाइंग नाउ कवरिंग अ लिटिल मोर अबाउट दिस एंटायर जर्नी सर फ्रेंकली स्पीकिंग टूडे द ग्रुप टर्न ओवर अगर मैं सेंचुरी सीमेंट दोनों की बात करता हूँ सर इट इज लाइक ऑलमोस्ट 4500 करोड़ प्लस सर हम लोग जब 2000 में शुरू किए थे और लाइक एट इफ आई टू से द टर्न ऑफ सेंचुरी सर उस समय आई थिंक वी वर टारगेटिंग 100 करोड़ दैट कुड हैव बीन अ मे बी नियर टर्म एस्पिरेशन तो सर लास्ट दो साल में फ्रॉम अ 100 करोड़ ग्रुप टू ऑलमोस्ट अ 4500 करोड़ ग्रुप the organization had faced various challenges various times sir aapko rebuild karna hua hoga aapne build kiya organization rebuild kiya similarly sir aapne team aisi banayi which is very very coherent काफी self driven and sir no working with you sir we know sir you give a lot of basically ownership to the people entrepreneurship culture hai aapke organization mein but sir if you can take through that journey of 100 crore to 4500 crores and what were the challenges in between and how you address those key challenges if you can say so that will be very very helpful
And you are asking about how I built up the organization and yes, the team. Is sir. That the question or
yes, absolutely,
I need to be absolutely clear?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, okay. So I tell you, when you start, suppose a very small business, at that time, the challenges are that one Sanjay Agarwal has to do from Juto Palisthi ke Chandi Paath. Bengali mein kahawat hai, ki you do from Juto Palisthi ke Chandi Paath. So everything, suppose a shop owner, He opens the shop, he directs the coolie, he manages the accounts, he manages the cash, he manages the banking, he manages every damn thing actually, he manages the suppliers, everything. So that is how practically every startup starts. Even today, if you look at the startups, that is what they do.
Yeah, sir.
Then the next step comes, at that time, you get some people. And you learn how to manage them. And they start working for you. But still, Sanjay Agarwal still calls the shots. Everything yes, comes sir. To Sanjay Agarwal and Sanjay Agarwal actually decides.
Yes.
I mean, Sanjay Agarwal means the owner, whoever Obviously. Is the owner, actually, he decides. Actually. So, the journey of that, iske baad ki jo situation aati hai na, We are yes, practically now ending that position where actually everything comes to Sanjay Agarwal. Yes. Some part of it has been shifted. But now we are learning by talking or using the top consultants or HRS, you know, people and all that. How the organization itself now can decide. Today the ideas come from a Sajjan Bhajanka or a Sanjay Agarwal.
Yeah.
The push comes from them. The whole organization gets motivated by because of these two or three people who actually keep the thing motivated. But now the time is coming when actually the organization needs to think, decide by itself, keep itself motivated. Yeah. So you see what we have been luckily, I should say that we have been doing is according to the time and the situation, we have changed ourselves. So it is not, you know, it is very good that if I eat the rasgulla, I enjoy it. So that is how, again, decision making and work is actually.
Yeah.
So, you know, when you do yourself, you enjoy it more.
Yeah.
So let it go to somebody else and empower him and look from distance and actually be patient when he's making a mistake as per you. So all these are learning, you see. Every entrepreneur learns it. We are still learning it. We have learned a part of it. So you see, in building up of the organization, this is one journey we have passed through and we have been doing a good job. That is how our organization. Number two thing in an organization built up is actually always you should have this mountain. This mountain excites the whole company, you see, there was a time when I said that we should achieve 25 crores in a year. Then 100 crore. At that time, you know, those are the mountains actually.
Yes,
now the mountains have totally changed. But for people and for some people, the present mountain is that I, because earlier it was 1 crore per day turnover.
Yeah.
Then now it is 1 crore per day net profit.
Okay.
But money no more excites us. Very frankly, it is not that is not the mountain for us anymore. But yes, for you know, the general and things, it is a mountain, and we find the small mountains and big mountains. I'm talking too much mountain actually. So ultimately, you need to keep them excited. And now the organization we are trying to build should be self-sustained organization, which will now decide, which will actually keep itself exciting. Excited. So there is the next journey is that for us actually. Why I'm trying to tell you, you know, the organization requirements and the mountains are changing, and we have been changing ourselves accordingly. Baki, if I go through the whole story, yes, there is a big story behind it. But if I tell you the whole story, it might be again, I think it's very boring. The most important thing is to get some people whom you can trust. And those people should be, you know, trusting in you. And then you need to empower those people. If an organization gets even 5% or 3% of such people in an organization will build. They will build the organization for you, actually.
Absolutely.
So that is how Century, from a very, you can say, I was the person who was sitting and who will do, call the dealer, talk to him, do the soda and, you know, send the material to him, and every damn thing we used to do, if there is a tax problem, so we will go and handle it ourselves, any damn thing. And from there to here now, actually, you know, all those things have totally gone out of our hands, and we don't do anything. I don't have anything to do on a daily basis, absolutely nothing. Okay. Only we are looking at ki tomorrow jo kuch aane wala hai, how to go beyond, how to, we are not doing a very good job presently, very frankly, but still, yes, we have not left it. And one more thing we have in the organization, which Mr. Bhajanka has given, that we have a CAGR system, that we must have a 15 to 20% CAGR planning and execution. So that again, you know, motivates us. Yeah. Last year, itna nahi hua, so now we need to, you know, catch up. And so all for that, you actually plan. I am talking very, very simple, you see, very frankly, I am not using the management words and the jargons and, you know, all those things, because that is how I am. I am educated in a Hindi medium school in Tinsukia, known as Hindi English High School. And English was a foreign language for me for a very, very long time. And still, if I watch an English movie, I have to see the subtitles, you see. Otherwise, I can't understand an English movie. So right now also, these are very simple things, but these are the things which can take anybody, even if you are working, even if you are a professional, the things are same, I'm telling you. I will tell you one more thing. No, I will save it for later right now. I will tell that at a little.
Sir, interestingly, sir, abhi aapne Sajan sir ka, Sajan uncle ka bola ki his concept of following a CAGR. And interestingly, sir, abhi ek hamari student hai, Shalini, she also mentioned about the compounding effect. So, taking a note on that, sir, I'll just share some interesting fact about it. Sir, Century Ply is considered like an HDFC bank of the century plywood industry, or like an Asian paint of the plywood industry. Sir, I have made stats. I will tell you. Sir, 27th May 1997 is when we got listed. Okay, sir. वहां से सर उस समय से अगर हम लोग देखते हैं हमारी शेयर प्राइसेस सबसे पहली बार 400 अभी बेसिकली आफ्टर द एडजस्टमेंट्स इट टच्ड ऑन जून 1 2021 ऑब्वियसली देवर हाइप्स ऑफ ऑफ टू एंटिटीज सर अगर मैं कंपाउंडिंग की इफेक्ट लेता हूं ना सर 27 मई 97 से लेकर सर एज ऑफ टुडे इफ आई टॉक अबाउट आवर शेयर प्राइसेस हैज कंपाउंडेड एट अराउंड 26% एंड डिविडेंड्स एक्स्ट्रा अगर मैं सर
आई डिडंट नो दैट
1 लाख रुपए लगाता सर आपकी आईपीओ में सर मेरे को 2.5 करोड़ रुपए मिलते More importantly, sir, Warren Buffett, who is considered as the basically the greatest of the investor, he had also compounded the wealth at around 20%, and we had actually been doing at 26% year on year. So that is a commendable feat for any investor who is looking at maybe India or specifically your company.
Thank you for the statistics.
Yeah,
it's a wonderful statistic you've given. Yes,
Vishal is a wealth manager, and I we can see from his talks. So thank you, Vishal. Sir, aapne abhi, actually, you have only mentioned about Bhajankar, sir, so many times in the previous conversation. So, wanted to take you into that topic. Now, we have seen so many stories in India where families did not get along well. I don't want to name it, and it resulted in value destruction of the entire business. We have seen quite a few unpleasant breakups in the corporate worlds also. But aapke case mein where you and Sajan, sir, you are not even blood related, right? If I'm not wrong. You possess diametrically opposite styles of leadership. Yeah. Could you please share your views on this key aspect? And how do you move along so friendly, so amicably, in spite of so many differences in your leadership styles?
You see, you have to look at what creates this problem between two people. You have any idea? Can you tell me something?
Both I think the first thing would be the difference in the way of working or way of dealing, way of taking decisions. So I think, yeah, that's the first thing.
Yes. And number two thing is, Vishal and Ramya is working together, and Vishal takes a decision where the company loses a lot of money, and then the Ramya is very, very, you know, disturbed that I told you, you don't take this decision, but you have taken.
I think it would be the other way around.
whatever. But you see, it is basically the most important thing is the respect for each other. I have to understand, or Ramya has to understand, that Vishal is no less than me. The problem is we think that I am a better person and Vishal is a little lesser person. But with Mr. Bhajankar, I am younger to him by 9-10 years, but he gives me the exactly the same respect and I give him the same respect. So the moment you give that respect, you see, everything changes. And you really don't, small things and all these problems are really not coming out of it. The problem you see with a husband and wife relationship, the only problem is the husband does not give the enough respect to the wife. The moment that it starts, things are going to change. Beginning. So in number one thing is this. Number two is, you see, we all ultimately dedicate our mind, body, spirit to doing what we are responsible for. Isn't it? So when I am doing that, and in that, Vishal, my partner, comes to me and he bloody does khoncha at every point. So that is not possible, you see. Then I will get disturbed. I will say either I disown it or I own it. It cannot. So Vishal can speak to me as a principal level. So the point I'm trying to tell you here is, let there be a division of responsibilities, execution responsibilities. As long as you are sitting in the board, you are discussing, you are, you know, strategizing, or you are planning, you all are thinking and taking a decision, then you follow the decision. But here, actually, now I have an area where I am executing, then bloody let me do it. If you don't like it, yes, let's have a meeting, let's discuss it out. But what I do in my zone, I will prevail. The third thing is, if I lose, still you don't grieve. If you lose, I don't grieve. And I tell you, I really don't feel bad about it. And the lesson I will tell you, a small story behind it, actually. So sometime long back, export profits were exempted from income tax in India. I don't know whether you know that. It was long back. So what we used to do, we used to export certain things out of the country, whatever we could understand in our limited knowledge. So we had exported flour, means maida, for worth 50 lakhs rupees to some Middle East country. And the prices had fallen. I was looking after that business. And the prices falls and the consignee refuses to take the material. And maida, as you know, is a, you know, perishable item, and in 2-3 months, though, it will go totally.
Yeah.
It is done vacuum pack, but still 2 months is maximum it can stay. So we realize it after 1 month that the things are really going bad, and now what to do? And we will lose 50 lakhs. at that time 50 lakhs was like, I could not even write down 50 lakhs, very frankly, that time I'm talking. So I went to Mr. Bhajanka, that Sajan Viya, this is what has happened and you please guide what to do. Mm-hmm. So he asked me, what can happen? Hambala, the worst is that 50 lakhs we can lose. And the second thing we can do is actually our export manager, we can send him to Dubai. And he can actually find out some buyer and maybe the goods worth 40 lakhs, maybe 50 lakhs, maybe sold for 40 lakhs, maybe for 30, whatever it is. Well, then you go, Sanjay, whatever you feel good, you do it. See, that was a learning for me. That was a training for me. That money really does not matter. Let us look at a solution, go ahead. We will, even if we lose, it does not matter. So we have lost a lot of money, a lot of failures we have passed through. But we have never felt bad about it. Even if we have felt bad, we have not expressed. We have kept the, you know, the respect. So I think these are a lot of gyan. I think that you don't require more gyan than this, actually, as far as the partnership. Today, every startup is a partnership, isn't it?
Yeah.
All the startups are collaborations. And isme ek cheez aur dimag mein rakhna chahiye, that the business, like Century Ply, is the most important thing. It is more important than you and me.
Exactly. Yeah.
Usually, hum log kya karte hain? We think I am more important than the business. Maybe initially, when you just start it, yes, I can agree to that. But then later on, when more people involve, when you're becoming bigger, there are Century Ply, there are 10,000 families which are dependent on a company like Century Ply today. So it is no more your business, boss. It is no more your business. It is a working for the society, it is working for the country. So your thoughts have to change now. The business is more important than a Sanjay Agarwal or a Sajan Mandinka, you see. The moment you realize this in your mind, everything changes for you.
Yeah. The bigger picture, the bigger goal.
So interestingly, yes, Bangalore can, is the city of new entrepreneurs, new age entrepreneurs, and Calcutta, yes, is considered as the city of the old age entrepreneurs. But these, yes, business principles continue to prevail. So, yes, like, yes, no, being in the industry and, sir, knowing you closely, sir, we are aware, sir, aapki jo partnership hai, it is considered like as a gold standard in the industry. Ki, sir, aap logon ne itne acche se isko chalaya, and that's why we are seeing the reflection in everywhere, the way the business has scaled up.
God help us.
Yeah.
Yes, we can go ahead.
Yeah, sure. Rame, you would like to take
it? Yeah, I'll take it. Yeah, so maybe one last or the second last question. B school students' ka favorite question about competition. So we know one watershed moment for the furniture industry in India particularly was the arrival of IKEA, right? And then now Godrej and many other players are also ramping up with their ready-made furniture. Then there are very cheap furnitures coming from China, so we cannot ignore. So there are too many businesses from different corners of the world with too many different business models. Now, we want to understand from you, sir, aapka strategy kya tha in this intensified competitive environment to maintain your leadership position. Aapka strategy kya tha right from the beginning, like from your growth stage to sustaining?
You see, my thoughts are completely different in this competition thing. You know, even earlier, I have told you, I have given you that Gandhi example, the difference in the soch of the people. Mm-hmm. So I don't think that competition hurts you.
Mm.
I think we become smarter. I think we learn a lot. I think they actually motivate us to do more. If there was no competition, because I don't have a very good competition, we have, otherwise, if I had very good competition, we would have been maybe 3-4 times what we are today. But because the competition is as bad as us, we are what we are today, very frankly. So competition always gives us more motivation. It gives us learning. So I don't think we should bother about competition. Yes, we should still again look at us internally. And I will give you an example. Like India, I think Pepsi came first or whatever, Coca-Cola came first, one of it. And when the other one came, there were a lot of talks about ki, ab kya hoga. But what happened, we all know. The market rather expanded. So IKEA coming in क्या करेंगे वो, 3,000 करोड़ बेच लेंगे, 4,000 करोड़ बेच लेंगे इन आने वाले समय 5-7 साल के अंदर निकल इंडिया के अंदर, बट दैट्स ओके. द होल बिजनेस इज बड़ी 30,000 करोड़ एज ऑन टूडे एंड इट इज नॉट द फर्नीचर इंडस्ट्री इज 80,000 करोड़ टूडे एक्चुअली. आउट ऑफ दैट इवन इफ दे गेट 3,000-4,000, बट यस नाउ वी आर लर्निंग, वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू बेटर. रेदर फॉर योर वी बिफोर आईकिया वी जम्प्ड इनटू फर्नीचर. Online also we have done. We have tried interior designing also online. Nestopia was our website actually. We worked for 5 years on it. Yes, we failed miserably. We were not ready for it probably. So we closed it down. Maybe in some time to come, maybe we will again get into it. So competition, I think, is a very good word. And I have spoken about the soch. So our thinking is, you know, one thing I can always tell you, one is quality. In the long run, if you are running a marathon or you are running a 100 meter race, you see, if you are running a 100 meter race, you can do whatever and maybe make some money or maybe lose some money. That's a different thing. But if you are there for long, if you are running a marathon, then quality. So our thought about, I will give an example of the termite proof thing.
Yeah.
For 50 years, plywood industry had this problem. Nobody bothered about this problem. And when we started plywood, I was called to Nasik into a housing area. And I was shown that, you see, all these places, you see the termite has infested all your plywood and please take back all the plywood. And that was probably within 3 months of my launching my plywood. So what we did? We did not accept it like that. We said, no, we have to know, if I am charging money for my goods, my customer cannot get that bad quality, you see. So we came back, we worked on it, we got a company from USA, they came here, they stayed here for months, they developed this thing for us, and till date, after that, we don't have a termite problem. So you see, a quality is a mindset, and that we have followed from very beginning. So this is how, you see, that, you know, there are another, I can give you more gyan on this and that, there are 10 things to, you know, as we learn in management institute, then they have to give you all the details and all the case studies and all that. So there's no point in getting into all the strategies we have taken. But what point is that you are live to that problem, that mountain. Again, there is a mountain. And you bloody say that, yes, I will win it. I will not let it go. Today, if I interview a person, I don't look at what are his learnings, because he knows more than that, because he has been working only into that sphere and HR. Suppose if it is HR, he's working in that property 25 years. What will I ask him? Mm. There's nothing for me to ask him, actually. He can take my class, actually, for next 1 month.
Yeah.
So the only thing, absolutely,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
So what we nearly only look at it is, what is his attitude? How he looks at life? What is his, you know, whether there is something burning inside him, whether he can, he really wants to work or he just wants to live.
Sure, sir.
If you have that fire inside you, or if you really want to achieve something, then learning that part is not a problem. The knowledge is not a big thing. Knowledge you can acquire. You see. Knowledge, you also know, knowledge is now no more a very important thing. Knowledge you can acquire, but that burning fire you cannot acquire, you see. That comes from within you. So yes, I think a lot of gyan I have given how competition or IKEA will do. IKEA will help us, I tell you.
Sure, sir. Sir, actually, there is so many questions which are flowing in the chat box, and there is already so many questions we had received. So before going into that, sir, I will just ask one last question, sir, actually. So now we have an audience which will be, say, nearer to, predominantly into the mid-30s, which is also similar to the Century Ply's age in terms of its existence. So the audience is predominantly future managers. So two things that I would like to ask under this question is, so one is, how would you basically put weightages to destiny versus mindset? So we had heard about mindset, but there's one aspect which is destiny also. So what is your thoughts on that? That is number one. And second is, sir, what would be your piece of advice to all the future managers and budding entrepreneurs, how to shape their career, sir?
So first I will speak just few lines on destiny actually. I believe, very frankly, I believe and I totally believe, yes, it is like that KRA or KPI, you see. So mm-hmm. you have so many KPIs, out of that, maybe that 5-10% is that luck part of it. So I have hit a second shot in my golf.
Okay.
And actually it lands on the green and then it rolls and rolls and it goes into the hole. See, so that you can say is a destiny, but destiny does not form a big part of our life. God has given us so much. So much power lies within us. And actually, if you really look at anybody, I'm telling you, you look at anybody who has succeeded, you will see that it comes from within. So destiny is, okay, it is just a small part of it. And whatever we cannot do, we just blame it. So it's a good thing. It's a good thing that, yes, there is somebody to blame. So in golf, whenever we hit a bad shot, we blame the caddy. Yeah. Or we blame the lie or something. We find an excuse, you see. But there is nothing more than that. Anybody can do anything. It all comes from here. You see, what happens? Suppose there is a assistant you have. You all have seen. You have all worked with people. So you will find a person is there who actually is very sincere, very thoughtful. Thoughtful, I'm using the word thoughtful about his work.
Mm.
But there will be people who will really not do the work and try to, you know, get by not doing it. I'm not talking at hard work, you see. I'm talking very thoughtful and smart work. So if he expects now growth, the second guy expects a growth in his life, do you think he will get it? Will you promote him?
Sir, for me, efficiency
no.
and effectiveness both no. go
yeah,
hand in
yeah.
hand.
So I suppose God has sent us here.
Yeah.
Do you think that God has sent us? Ki jao beta, main tere ko sab kuch main hi kar dunga. Then why has He sent us?
We have
to. So it is not the destiny. You see, we have to understand it. It is not the destiny. It is me. It is within me. Yes, destiny thoda bahut part play karta hai. I agree to it. I cannot deny it. Nobody can deny it. But it is not the whole thing. So yeah. That was the first part. The second part we come is how you become successful. Again, I will ask you a question here. So you know that in Calcutta, there was a bridge, Vivekananda Bridge.
Yeah.
So now the question is to Ramya actually. Because
I have never been to Kolkata. But
okay, so this bridge, what happened? This bridge was being made and this was going to be inaugurated. And before, about a month before the inauguration, the bridge broke. It fell so badly that you can't understand how many people died into that.
Oh.
So I want to ask you a question, why it fell?
There could be a culmination of bad decisions taken into the construction.
Good.
But
then you understand, ultimately it was only one thing. Either it was a bad design or it was bad cement, kamti cement dala hoga ya balu jada dala hoga or whatever, you know, or the workmanship was not good. So you see, all these things are only one thing actually. The weakness was within the flyover. Am I getting to you?
Mm-hmm.
So if your flyover, you as a man, if you fail, it is you. It is the weakness in you. Nobody, I tell you, nobody outsider can, they can just give you some gyan. Main yahan gyan de raha hu, aap sun rahe ho. I can tell to mere jaise gyan bahut aap din bhar IIM mein bhi itna le rahe hoge, but it is the weakness inside you which will kill you. Nobody else, neither your boss. Ye kya karte hai na, jo ladkon ko main dekhta hu, they always sir. That sir cannot do anything. If you have the it inside you, your sir will actually call you. He will hug you and he will tell you, beta, tu aage jayega, tere ko ye karna padega. Or the boss ka boss tumko bula lega. Kahin na kahin, tumme jadi light hogi, that light will be seen. Hum log hi usko kya karte hain? We get satisfied. Kya hai yaar jindagi mein? People tell that story, that person is sleeping under the tree. You all must have heard.
Hmm.
somebody from Bombay came, went to him and asked कि तू ये टाइम क्यों खराब कर रहा है, तू ये कर, तो तुमको तो बोला क्या होगा, तो बोला उससे तुमको ये मिलेगा, फिर घर मिलेगा, पैसे आएंगे, बोला उससे क्या होगा, बोला तुम उसके बाद में बड़ा आराम से जिंदगी जिएगा, बोला और कर क्या रहा हूँ ठीक है ना. सो एक्चुअली यू नो दैट इज वन एटीट्यूड. यस ही इज राइट, बट देन दैट इज वन एटीट्यूड. सो यू हैव टू डिसाइड
व्हाट आई
वांट इन माय लाइफ. सो द बाकी मैं जितना भी ज्ञान तुम लोगों को दे दूं वो ठीक है. एक ज्ञान और देता हूँ विच इज नॉट वेरी प्रोबेबली आई डोंट नो हाउ यू टेक इट बट आई हैव अ लाइन. यू विल regret, you can note down the line I'm telling you, all the people who are hearing, and read it again, I'm telling you. You will regret the mistake you have not made. You have not made, I'm telling you. And it is not only applicable in your personal life, it is applicable in business also. There are things I regret. I should have done it then. Why I did not do it? Whatever I did and failed, I don't regret. The regret has gone. Oh, temporary, you know, regretfulness tha, very temporary tha. But what I have not done is still haunting me. So agar, suppose if I say in now in a very lighter mood, suppose if you want to go and run or dance in rain, what are you waiting for? Please go and do it. If you want to get drunk, go ahead and do it. Don't eat the dosa only. You see, you are actually killing the work. If you are only working, then you are getting bored of every part of your body, mind and spirit is getting bored of it, I'm telling you. And you will not be able to deliver work. So you need to actually, this line you remember in your life and tell to others, you will regret the mistakes you have not made. Yes, it is very, very important. Then, बहुत कुछ करने को है. आप जब इस लाइन को पढ़ोगे तो देन यू विल रियलाइज अभी भी ऑलरेडी एट योर एज आल्सो देयर आर सो मेनी मिस्टेक्स यू हैव नॉट मेड. सो गो अहेड.
आई मस्ट से सर, आई मीन दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ऑथेंटिक एंड रॉ कन्वर्सेशंस दैट आई हैड विद लीडर्स सो फार. मतलब स्ट्रेटजीज, कंपटीशन, नॉलेज सारे बेस कोर्स पढ़ाते हैं, सारे तुम्हारे मैनेजर्स भी तुमको इतना ज्ञान देते हैं, बट दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉक हैज बीन सोल लिफ्टिंग फॉर मी एटलीस्ट. Attitude molding and whatnot. So yes, I have taken back a lot of learnings from this session, and I must thanks Vishal for getting you here. We are extremely humbled to have you here. I think Vishal, I'll give it to you now.
Yeah, we can ask some
absolutely sir.
Questions so, from these people, whoever sure. you think.
Yeah, like so, the coffee questions.
Sir. So there are so many questions. So we have our cohort member Srinath, who will sir moderate the questions from the audience. Yeah.
There's one more thing, actually. I don't know if there is a question on brand. Has anybody asked?
Yeah, sir. There is one question that is coming on the brand.
Then okay.
Sure. That is favorite question is branding. Yeah.
Thank you, Vishal. Thank you, sir, for this enlightening session. Now we'll go to the Q&A part of it.
Yeah. Hi, Srinath.
Hi, sir. So first question we have from Jitin Krishnan. Jitin, can you mute? Unmute yourself and ask your question, please.
Jitin, you can unmute.
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, Jitin.
Thanks, Srinath. Thanks, Sanjay sir, for taking the time this morning to speak to us. I had a bit of a macro question to ask you, which is, I think the finance minister had said in 2019 that we are headed to become a $5 trillion economy. And in between, since 2019, we've had a couple of rough years as an economy. So I think my question to you as an industry leader is whether or not you think that's possible, and if it is, as an industry leader, what you'd like to see from the industry itself and the government to sort of enable something like that to happen. Or I think if I have to use your phrase, what mistakes should be?
I understand the question, and it's a good, very good question actually. And I can tell you one thing, that Indian industry or the Indian entrepreneur or the Indian professionals are absolutely ready to reach that goal. We need to understand that it is, we are being, you know, regressed for not achieving that. Instead of giving us that push, that floor the accelerator, we are being pulled back actually by different things. Otherwise, the Indian industry, professionals, Indian professionals have achieved what not, tell me, what not. So it is, it will be achieved, it must, should be achieved. And as far as what should the government and the industry should do, you see, in India now, if I speak here, I'm sure, because in India we can voice our you know, thoughts, nobody minds. But whatever I speak, neither the government will hear, nor we will act upon it. But still, it is in my mind, so I can tell you. You see, you don't have to go anywhere, but we need to understand how somebody else did it. So that I have seen China, when China used to import plywood from across the world in 1993. I have exported plywood to China. And today, China is the largest supplier of plywood across the world. We have seen... America becoming America. So when we go to China or when we go to USA, what do we see? What they have really done? How they have achieved it? So there are some simple things. You see, I look at things very, very simply. I don't look at the paraphernalia of it. Yes, everything has a lot. So the first question I ask the government, if anybody hears, is that, yes, we have increased the budget for infrastructure by 34% in the last budget to 5,80,000 crore or whatever, something actually. Also, I think that's about half a trillion or something, something like that actually. So I am asking the question that why don't we decide that we will invest 15 lakh crore? Why 5,80,000 crore? India does not have any infrastructure today. If you get down to a... we don't have even a, you know, a port for getting a, you know, these ships which carry passengers. There are not very good roads. There are not very good, you know, anything. Yes, we have done great job in last few years, in last maybe 10, 15 years, a lot of things has happened. But why not we can invest in instead of 5 lakh 80 hazar crore, why can't we invest 15 lakh crore or 20 lakh crore into infrastructure, and that will fuel everything. You tell me one item which will not be touched by that actually. But I think the only reason government is not doing is that it will, because they have to print notes. And if you print notes, there is a inflation.
Yeah.
So again, I feel, that is again my small mind and small thoughts, that as se 20 saal pehle, if you print notes, the economy was very small. So the supply became lesser, the demand became more. So the inflation was high. In today's times, you have seen how after COVID, the gloves industry or the anything which was required has been geared up so fast. Even a vaccine has been produced within, say, 6 months, and we have geared up within 1.5 years, we have geared up to vaccine the whole world. So I don't think today spending money will bring inflation. It may bring inflation for a very small time. So that is one thing I will suggest to the government, if they hear, of course, that we must print notes, but our budget must go through the roof for infrastructure. That is number one. And number two, for industry, I believe today, if I want phenol or if I want any raw material, critical raw material for any of these medicines, or for your computer, if you want a chip, all these things are not manufactured in India. Can we identify those? And then, instead of subsidizing it by money, subsidize it by inputs. Like for them, you can say that the interest burden will be only 3%, equal to the world level for you. Or maybe the energy, like if for plywood, how plywood industry developed in China. What China government did was one area, they created so much of energy resources, and they said, as many industry you put, and I will, the energy is free for you. The electricity is free for you. There was no money transacted, you see. But you take the energy, you take the electricity. And thousands of entrepreneurs came there and they actually became the largest producer of plywood. And they did not subsidize even a single paisa by money. So these are the small things, you see. And I'm sure there are many economists sitting there. There is a full, you know, advisory panel and they are certainly thinking all this. They must be having their own problems. So yes, that is how I think 5 trillion economy. Yes, we will achieve. I'm 100% sure.
Sir, is it okay if we can extend the session a little bit because there are a lot many questions that are coming up?
If you all are interested, main to gyan de raha hu.
Definitely. See. So there's so many questions which are there. So Yashri, you can go ahead.
Thanks for that elaborate answer, sir. We have the next question from Mamta. Mamta, can you please unmute?
Yeah. Good morning, sir. Today we see a new breed of budding first-generation entrepreneurs who are riding the tech wave, who are trying to create brands that last. You have already created powerful brands, which are all practically the largest in their segments, be it Century Ply, Star Cement, or Sainik, which are market leaders in rural India. We'll be really delighted to know what is your recipe of creating these power brands time and again. More importantly, those brands which could connect with Indian customers so well.
Good. And again, this is a question which I really love. And without this, I think any management talk is useless. So I will give you a small story behind it. So we launched our this plywood in 1995, I think, or 94 we launched. And I was in Bombay visiting a shop. And at that time, Kitply was number one in the country. So this shop owner was trying to manipulate me. He showed me my plywood. It had a small speck, a black speck, very, very small black speck there actually on the face of the plywood. And he told me, sir, ye nahi chalega. Isko aap wapas le jaiye. Achha, main bhi naya naya hoon, you see, in the business of plywood. I really don't understand plywood very well then. But then idea came to my mind then and there. I told him, achha, okay, what is the best plywood? Bula, sab Kitply. Bula, sab Kitply nikalo. So he took out the Kitply. That Kitply bloody had 200 specs of like that. It had many joints. Part of it was black. On the sides, you could see a lot of gaps. I said, yeah, there is no comparison. My plywood is actually gold in front of this. This is not even iron. Bole, saab, wo Kitply hai. People demand it. Aapke maal ko mere ko bechna padta hai. So what a lesson in branding, you see. So that is where I learned my lesson of branding. And after that, I don't need any other lesson in branding. So today, if I remove the word Century Ply from my plywood, I have a question to you, Mamta, isn't it? The person who asked the question, or Sri, maybe you
yes,
can answer.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So if I remove the word Century Ply from my plywood, what will happen?
It loses its identity, the connection, probably.
Will I be able to sell the quantity I sell?
No.
Will I be able to fetch the price I fetch?
Definitely not.
Then, so that is the importance, the strength of a brand. Without brand, we are nothing. You see, everything else is false, whether it is factory or my office, or even I will say cash. Cash bhi mil jata hai. People also mil jate hai. People is, of course, that is the second in my list, actually. People is the second on my list. But brand, there is nothing, nobody can work without a brand. Even I tell you, even where you live and you go out to buy a small thing, suppose some chocolate or some paan or maybe some chai, you go to a particular shop, there is a Visal tea or there is a Kumar, store. That's a local brand. Why don't you go to the another 10 stores, but you go to bloody that single store only every time you go out? It's a brand. Hai ki nahi? So brand is everything. हम लोगों को लगता है ब्रांड पे हम खर्चा कर रहे हैं, इट इज यूजलेस, ये वो, बट ब्रांड इज एवरीथिंग, एवरीथिंग एल्स विल कम. So I think I have answered your question. I don't need to tell you how we build up the brand. There are gurus, there are many, many people who will tell you how to build a brand, because every brand needs different strategy, different actions in the market and timeline. All those things are, but you must understand in your mind that yes, this is the very most important thing and I must invest my time. The topmost person in the company must invest his time and money onto it. Without that IIM, you are talking, asking question of brand. Why did you go to IIM? Why you did not go to some you know, institute next to my factory?
Yes, sir. Thanks a lot. You have more than answered, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. We have a question from Amit. It's an interesting question. Amit, can you please unmute yourself?
Hello. Thanks. Thanks, Sri. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I think amazing insights, Sanjay ji. I think I got to Thank learn a lot of stuff you, this morning. I have this question on ESG and corporate governance. And I see you operate in a segment where you face a lot of challenges time and again in sourcing your raw material. Also, this environmental laws, which we are seeing are becoming stringent day by day. The global climate challenge also is an issue which we are hearing, reading. And yesterday only we celebrated this UN Environment Day. So how do you see these challenges haunting you sometimes, and how are you maneuvering these challenges time and again?
I'm so thankful to you for asking this question, actually. I will be able to clarify the mind of at least these 100 people who are connected right now. Have you heard very recently in last year that the total forest coverage in India has grown remarkably? Have you heard this news? If you have not heard, you should go online and check. Have you thought why it has increased? Jabki itna plywood banne lag gaya sala, itni paper ban raha hai, because paper also uses timber. Have you ever thought? I will give you the reason here. It's a simple thing. You see, earlier, till 1996, people used to cut forests to make plywood or to make paper. In 1996, Supreme Court of India banned cutting of forest, total ban. Even if I cut one tree in my golf club, we have to take a permission. So the deforestation completely stopped. Yes, there might be, you know, in certain areas, some people are cutting some timber because they live there, they are Banvasis, and that is their distinct. So very, very minuscule, I must say, is that area. The rest of it has stopped. What has happened after that? Now India grows and it is increasing year by year, is a plantation timber which can be cut from 3 to 10 years, depending on the variety of tree you plant. And all, whether it is ITC has done a great job, you can go and read, actually, they are one of the pioneers into it. But you look at any paper industry, or if you look at a century ply, what we do is the saplings. We buy the saplings and subsidize it and give it to farmers. In India, you cannot own land. In America or in China, the land is so huge that you can land large part of land and you can plant. Here, you cannot. So what we do is we motivate the farmers. The farmers are planting it and it is available for cutting, and we have an agreement with them that if you cannot sell it outside, we will buy at this price. That price is at least double or 5 times its cost. So that is why you will see this Harit Kranti, ya bol sakte ho ek tarah ka. If you go to Punjab, Himachal, or even if you go to Karnataka or Andhra particular zones, you will see that every farmer, wherever he's planting his cash crops, because those are cash crops, which every 2-3 months they can cut and get some cash. But the rest of the area, or on the crossings, or on the, you know, made bolte hain usko, where one part of the field is connecting to the other part of the field, the small areas. Wahan par hai, so they plant these trees, which after 3 to 6 years, they give him a lot of money. So that is why today plywood industry is not an environment against industry or environment killing industry. It is actually an environment friendly industry today. Even a paper is an environment friendly industry. we import some timber, which is, you can say, maybe 3 to 4% of our total consumption, which is imported from places like Europe or maybe in certain places in Africa, where it is maintained, the whole chain is maintained. And they have a cycle of 30 years where actually they plant and they cut only as much as they can grow in 30 years. So the whole scene has changed, actually, that one single action of Supreme Court of India. So I hope I have answered you that E part of it. Now S and the G, S is, of course, yes, we all do. So I will not comment on S. Yes, we do a lot of community surveys or social surveys and all that we do. So that is okay. And we are not dedicated from today, but from the very first day, we dedicate a small percentage from 1986. We have a percentage which we use for the society. So today, actually, this thing has come up 2%, but we do it more than that since 1986. I will come to G, the governance part of it. I tell you, if a company does not have absolute governance, corporate governance, don't touch the company, don't talk to the company. Absolute, I'm using the word absolute. There is no, yes, we do 1% here or aadha percent there or vaise nahi. I am proud to tell you that Century Ply, from the day we became a public company. Before that, yes, it was very easy. Whatever money we made, we divided between Mr. Bhajanka and Sanjay Agarwal and we took home. So that was a different time. But after that 1997 thing, every penny is counted and we don't spend. If I have gone to Bombay and for 2 days I am working and 1 day I am doing for my personal use, that 1 day will be debited everything to my account. To that extent, I am saying. So everything, our governance is absolute. We don't compromise. So I put Century Ply and Star Cement as, if you count the top 10 top corporate governance companies, our company should be there. Of course, we are still very small, so people don't recognize. But so that is how I answer your ESG.
Thanks, sir. Thanks for the insight, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to take a question from the chat box. Ayan Mitra has a question. Can you please unmute Ayan, Kumash?
Hello, sir. I am also from Kolkata, born and brought up there. So now very happy to hear you and very. So I had a question. It has always been on my mind. So when you get your first failure, how do you convince somebody to actually put money in your ventures? It must have be very difficult. And how do you decide? Should you go with the same amount you have risked in your first venture, or you bring down that amount, or how do you decide that amount and how do you get that amount people to back?
Actually, I don't have answer for this question, because when we were, in that stage, at that time, we were not taking money from venture capitalist and all that. They did not exist. So we had our own money, or we were borrowing from our friends and all that. We were just borrowing. So there was no capital. Ab aaj ki date mein what happens? I think there are better people to answer this question. Sorry, I don't have the answer to this question, actually.
No problem, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. We have a question from Shreyas.
Hi, Shreyas.
Hello, sir. Thank you for the wonderful talk today. My question is on brand again. Century Ply is obviously a fantastic brand. Honestly, I don't know any other ply brand today apart from yours.
Thank you.
And I noticed that you have used several mediums to spread the name and grow the brand. And television is a big part of that. My question is regarding news channels in particular. Today, it's quite evident that the quality of news channels is not so good. Anything and everything is said. Do you think that sponsoring news channels affects your brand? And is that something you're concerned about?
You see, what you have seen is news channel, but I must tell you that online or internet is a very big portion of our brand building today. It's a very big portion, actually. The whole team is working on that. But coming to your question, yes, you are right. So I have a question to you, actually, in answer. So there are many people in this country who love Modi.
Yeah.
And there are many people who hate Modi. Okay. Yeah. So now I only asked them a question ki today as a leader, if not Modi, who?
Right.
Okay, na?
Are you asking me the question?
So the answer to this question is, if you do not, suppose you are saying that the new channels are not doing a very good job, but whatever brands are being formed, are being launched, they are getting their visibility on those new channels only.
Right.
Very, very few brands can go to, even if you go to the entertainment part of it, the entertainment channels, even they are not doing very well. Tell me one program which you really see that, yes, this is a program I really love and I really, everybody wants to watch. There are no more Mahabharat or Ramayans or, you know, that kind of serials which used to come earlier and used to attract. There is so much of fragmentation. You are watching now Netflix. Pehle ye nahi tha, last ek saal mein toh, now you have got Netflix and Hotstar. So, you see, in sometimes you elect a Modi. I'm not against Modi, but I'm saying you elect a Modi because there is nobody else. So that is how we also do the same thing here. Yes, even we are not happy with what we are doing, but you have no choice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the candid answer.
Thank you, sir. We have the last question from Umesh.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, Umesh, yes. I can see you all too, actually.
Yeah, thank you so much for such an insightful session, sir. As a young entrepreneur, how can one reach out to you and learn from you? Are you active in social media or any other platform?
Yes, I am active on Facebook mostly, but not so. Whenever I achieve something, like I did I like to brag about it. So I got a chance to brag right now. So I will brag about it a little bit. I did that 100-kilometer walk in the Mulsi Hills near Bombay. And I think that was the most foolish decision I have ever taken. But today I'm so proud of it, you see. So I put up that photo. So if I run a half marathon, then I put up that photo that, yes, I have run a half marathon and I want to showcase. But usually you will not find, otherwise I am putting a photo every day or I am giving a gyan there, because I don't think people are really looking for gyan too much. There is so much gyan in last 1.5 years, so has been a flood. The whole world is inundated in gyan now, actually. So yes, if you want to ask some questions or if you want to interact, Vishal is known to you. You can write to Vishal. Vishal can always talk to me. We can talk otherwise also. But my gyan will be always like this, very simple, straightforward, to the point. There are no jargons. There are no, you know, theories, nothing like that, actually. So yes, I am there on social media and very little. So there, actually, I use it for my satisfaction, you can say.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot, sir. It was a really great session with all the Q&A and all the experience shared by you. And now I hand over the session to Rahul, who will make the closing remarks. Thank you.
Thank you, Shri. A very good afternoon to respected Sanjay ji, all the esteemed panelists, and all the dear participants. Good afternoon, sir. I'd like to give a vote of thanks to everyone. So to respected Sanjay ji, your session was very insightful and it was very inspiring to everyone. We got to know your journey, the challenges you faced and how you overcome them by accepting your failures and embracing them and continuously adapting to overcome them. We learned about fitness, work-life balance, discipline, partnership, competition, and we also got some relationship advice on the way. We loved your teachings on loving our failures and treating every problems as opportunities would stay with us for long. Hopefully, we will identify our own mountains, our Everest, we'll climb them and conquer them eventually. We thank you for taking time out today to help us, to guide us, and thank you for your candid discussion with us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So very wonderful, all of you, to actually invite me. It was a pleasure, and it was my respect I got. I'm proud of it that you have invited me. Thank you. And don't forget, you will regret the mistakes you have not made.
Definitely, sir. We also thank Sanjay ji's friends and families who are present with us today, attending the session. So thanks a lot.
Thank you.
To them as well. We would like to thank Professor Gopal Mahapatra, who is PGPM chairperson, PGPM office and IT team, who helped us conduct the session. We have had over 100 plus participants today, attendees. So thanks a lot to them. We like to thank the organizing committee here, Ms. Anisha Jain, Ms. Anupama, Mr. Jitin, Mr. Mahalingam, Ms. Mamta, Ms. Radhika, myself, Ms. Ramya, Mr. Srinath, Mr. Ramesh, and Mr. Vishal. It was all collective effort because of which we could deliver the session today.